崭新的开放民主平台，还有在体制内的数位民主革命。So please let me your hands to your Tom Miguel.
Thank you very much. I'm going to focus first for a while on the civic part of the civic tech that we're talking about, because I think it's very important to understand the social movement and the political movements that are going on to be able to develop the right technology. If we don't understand the characteristic of the movement, we cannot do the right technology. This is the famous Square of Madrid in Spain.And a photograph of 2011, the beginning of 2011. That was a bit after the Arab Spring started, the revolution in the Arab countries, that we watched with surprise. And it was somebody there about the situation in Spain. Probably everybody would answer two things. First, things cannot be changed in Spain.This kind of change could happen in the Arab countries also. It was a big surprise for us, but when it happened then, everybody said, of course, there were dictatorships, it happened there. But not in our country, it's very difficult. You have the political system, the media, nothing can change. And second, now we don't care about politics. Now we don't care, people don't care about politics. So nothing similar is going to happen here in Spain. Just some days,After this picture, we have this other picture of the same story. 10,000 people doing an assembly, thinking together on politics and how to change the country. Just some days after we find this kind of society. It's always like this. Unexpected, people cannot predict. People think that in their country that never happens, and then we have this kind of things. That happens in every country that there was a similar moment, always.So let me explain you some characteristics of these kind of movements, at least as we live in Spain. The first is, this is not a demonstration, this is an assembly. It's absolutely crucial. A demonstration is an action where you look to the people in power and you ask for change. An assembly, you turn back to the people in power and you look to the other people and sit together to think about the change you want to do and how to make it real.It's a totally different perspective. One of the words that define this is open. It's an open struggle. Everybody can go there, join the movement, go out. It's open for everybody. And this is very important because this is where the potential of change lies. That the people can join and then we all together can be able to change things. This is the strength that people being able to join. Also the horizontality. All the voices count the same.They're not leaders, they're not hierarchies. We just sit together and together we try to reach consensus and to do change. This is something, this concept that are not understood by all politics and media. When we talk about open, they ask, yeah, yeah, but are you left wing or right wing? As the movement said in its own words, we are not from left, we are not from right, we are the ones in the bottom, and we are going to get the ones in the top.It's a movement that always is pretending to be explained by the crisis. It happened in the countries because they have dictatorship. It happened in Spain because they have a political crisis. And it's never like this. Also, said in the words of the movement, it is not a crisis, it is the system. Or in another version, it is not a crisis, it's that I don't love you anymore.It's a movement that also uses a lot of humor, creativity to connect with everybody. It's a movement that started in Spain with this slogan, Real Democracy Now. And this was the first demonstration that we had just before the movement started. And this is quite a strange slogan for demonstration because we were supposed to have a democracy in Spain. We had, as it was explained, two parties that were changing the power, these two parties had elections, and suddenly people started to realize the thing that maybe it was not a real democracy, maybe they were not taking the control of what was happening in the country. So it's something that really goes, sooner the people join and start thinking, goes deeply into the structure of the system. And it's a global union, which is very, very, very important. We saw the same in Greece, in Egypt, in Turkey, in the streets, in Israel, now in France, and always we see the same. It is a movement. People that join together to talk, to decide to make changes, open, horizontal, that way. And it's very important because what I'm talking about now is not about Spain. I'm talking also about Taiwan. We are talking about the same things together. And it's a movement that learned from one from each other. Thanks to what happened with the Arab Spring, we saw that kind of action, people going to the square in camps, and we said, okay, we can do the same, and it was a total success. Each time we learn the action, the method, the tool that we use, each time we improve. So each time we have much, much more power to change things. To make the story short, after 4 years of huge mobilizations in Spain, we had the camps at the beginning in the square. We had a huge movement to fight for public education system. We had a huge movement to fight for the public health system, for fight for the right of housing to stop the evictions. In Spain, we had 300 evictions every day, 300 families that left their houses. After a lot of mobilization, and after we saw that the politicians never cared about what we were doing, even when all these movements had already around 80% of support of the population, people say, okay, if you're not listening to us, we are going to go also inside the institution, we are going to take you out, and we are going to change the system. So we are going into a new phase, going to the institutions. We started making political progress. This is a different kind of game because political parties have structures, they have leaders. You are playing a different kind of game. But we try to make it as open and as horizontal as it was the movement, using the same characteristics. So the new political parties that we made in Spain, for example, were all the candidates were totally open. Everyone could just join, propose himself, and we had online voting for the candidate list. And we have a very interesting mixture between activists, people coming from all political parties, independent people, a lot of ideologies in the party. Also the programs. Of course we have to do working groups, there were people working in them, but then we put on the internet, working both for the different measures, the priorities of the political parties. And we use always a word that is very important for us, instrumental political parties. These political parties are just tools to go into the system and hack it. They are not meant to be there forever, grab the power and stay there. We always have to focus us in the assemblies in the ideas, not in the game of power. It was a total success. 1 year ago, we built new political parties in every city, in almost every city in Spain, and we won the governments of almost every major city in Spain. In Madrid, in Barcelona, in Coruña, in many, many, many cities. Parties that didn't exist maybe 6 months before the elections, just people joined, and with internet, doing crowdfunding, without any economic support of the media, we grew the parties and we were able to win. Because we let everybody take control of the parties, of their ideas, to take control of the campaigns. This is how we were able to do it. And now we are governing in Madrid, where working and other things. So, once we are inside, we have to take the system and change and using the same characteristic of outside. This is Design Madrid, is the citizen participation platform that we built from scratch for the city of Madrid, where we are driving the direct democracy mechanism that we are starting. We have, for example, a section for proposal. People can propose whatever they want, people can support all the proposals, and we are weeks to the 2% of the support of the population, we do a referendum, a binding referendum. This is very important. This is not petition. We are not asking the politician to do something. People propose, people decide, and politicians obey. It's very important that we focus on this kind of also mechanism and technology, not to put pressure on politicians, just to organize within themselves and let just the people, the politicians do what people decide. It's about the summer with them, the top 10% of the collective support right now. But for example, people are caring about having the same ticket for the public transport, something about the city. They are caring about creating a network of bike lane or the free flow to information service of the city. But also, they are caring about other big problems like stop bullfighting, that is a hot issue in Spain. About some people are proposing that the church should pay the property taxes to abolish the gag law that we have, a law that is freedom of expression, that we have a category of law in Spain. So we mix a lot of issues, very local issues and huge issues. People are setting the agenda, not the politician. We have spaces where people can directly connect with the politician or people inside the city council. Yeah, a politician comes, people do questions, people vote for the question, and then the politician answers the question. People do the question and select which one should be answered. We have media, we have any kind of censorship directly. We have participatory budget. This year, for the first time, we have 60 million euros of investment that are going to be decided by the people, just by the people. People propose. People decide how to the best proposal, and then we spend the money. Today, actually, in 1 hour, we open the final voting phase of this process, just exactly 5 years after the first camps in the squares. Exactly the 15th of May, 5 days ago, we started with the movement, and now people are deciding how to spend the budget of the city. Also, after the movement faded away, the camps disappeared from the square, and a lot of people said, well, you see, you didn't change anything. We are changing everything. There are also cooperative legislation. This is the example of the law for transparency in the city. Before moving, it is there, you could comment just on the specific settings, actually. We are collecting the platform on the basic direct democracy mechanism that are really in all around the world, all the institutions in the platform, and make it easy so everybody can join and really take the decision. And not only this big mechanism, we are also doing very specific participation processes about the redevelopment of the city, about the doing a human rights process, some disabilities, many other processes. We are improving every day. This platform started just like 7 months ago, it's brand new, but already allows us to do all this kind of process. And of course, it's free software. From the first line, it was there on GitHub. Dozens of developers joined us and started doing the code with us as they were working in city council. Not only in the digital space, but also having physical meetings where the developers of the city go there, in the public center, and other developers can join hackathons. It's available for everybody. This platform very fast spread to other cities. Now it's been used in Barcelona, in Oviedo, in A Coruña. There are 40 to 50 cities in Spain and some cities also outside of Spain that in the next month they're going to start using it. It's also the same idea as before. We learn, we can reuse the tools. So we want also to offer this platform for Taiwan. I don't know if there is still some Taiwanese politicians here, but it's there. You can use it. It's free, we prove it works, it can work inside a big institution in Spain. There's a 3.2 million people, so really scale to all levels. So there are no excuses for not using it. We challenge you really to let the people take the decisions on their life and their country. Last message for the movement that we have. During the movement, the Stop Eviction Movement, this movement that was fighting for the right of housing, someone collected 1.5 million signatures to change the law on housing. The support of this change was that 80-90% of the population supported this change. And the politicians did nothing. Nothing. The message they were using in the demonstration was, it can be done, but they don't want. Please join us. Let us make the politician don't take a decision in your name. Let nobody decide in your name in which kind of world you want to live. Thank you.
要提问的，不用说非常精彩。好，那我们就一起后面那位女士。
我们是想讲，有关马德里的提案的系统，那跟之前过去比较起来，是否会比较偏向短程的一些计划，而缺乏长程的一些建设计划，或者是定点的部分？
Sorry, you mean operating with the system with the bus? You mean the system where there was not this kind of participation system?
Maybe said the system is more like a short-term plan, not long-term strategy.
Depends on the participation mechanism. We have some, like for example, the participatory budget that aims really to spend the money on the next year, something short-term.The other mechanism depends on what people are proposing. Some of the proposals are really short-term, and some are for long-term projects. So really, it's up to the people what they want to decide. We don't set the agenda. We can start also process longer, short-term process, but the important thing is there is a place where people decide exactly what they want to do about anything.
Hi, I know you're relatives of Democracy of SOS in Argentina. The question is quite simple. Why did you start from scratch, and what do you think about the fact that there are many different experimentations of different platforms?
We worked with, just last year we were really studying all the platforms that were available, and we didn't find any platforms that was really ready to do all these kind of huge processes and really use the important functionalities to make the process really work. The problem we are facing with this kind of process is sometimes a problem of scale. In the proposal section of the mechanism, we have 11,000 proposals for the moment, so it's really a hugeproblem of complexity.
And is that a technical difference, or like encoding an infrastructure, or it is a design difference?
It's a thing of only design, on how the people interact with the platform. We are trying to use the functionalities of other platforms on the internet, like that are ready to allow this kind of complexity, that hundreds, thousands of people join together and select the best content and vote.And some other platforms that are available are not really prepared for this, because they are prepared for experiments on participation on really small scales. They're usually, politicians are afraid of the people, they are afraid of having this kind of system, so they don't need a platform that really allows a massive participation. So in that sense, we really needed to design something a bit better than some other system, and more full, and also we are trying to design very flexible.Because since the platform is spreading to many other cities, maybe some of the cities want to use some process, some of the process not, or they want to design their own process. So we are thinking from the structure of the platform to design so people can design their own modules and grow as very flexible and decentralized into the other platforms don't allow.
Thanks. Actually, we're running out of time. Short question, okay?
Thanks for a great talk and sharing a great story. I'd like to ask that how to connect the system to politicians. I mean, how to pursue politicians to participate with this system. What's the first step?
Well, we could connect because we have a new kind of politician that really were citizens that got into politics. We needed to bring to be this other tool, this instrumental political parties together and the same thing.But I think now maybe it's going to be easier, because when you prove it works in some countries, it's easier to go to other countries or the politicians and say like, okay, we want this, so it's working, and they offer you this, so use it. I think this time it's going to be easier. As it was easier for us, like when we saw the Arab Spring, we saw them having this action, and we said, okay, they're going to do the same.
好，谢谢Miguel。